This one, the sneaky green man. So it's 21st Amendment Saison, sneak attack Saison. It is a Saison brewed with cardamom. Shout out to Effortless Brew It. What's up, my brother? I know you dig on some cardamom. And then the bottom is Green Man Porter. So, cheers. Lovely. Getting some pretty wicked lava lamp action going on. And that's a pretty hazy Saison. There's a whole bunch of stuff floating around in there. Pretty decent separation. That's good. That Saison is good. 6.2% on the Saison and 6% on the Porter. So I think that just reinforces my final gravity theory on the will it float? So how's everybody? I am doing all right. I've got a weekend finally. Been waiting for this Friday since Monday. I don't know about y'all, but that's where I'm at. It's been actually a pretty decent week, all in all. No major events, no catastrophes, so can't complain about that. The only catastrophe was I needed to ship some beers up to the Pabst Mansion West, and I wanted to get those out on Tuesday or Wednesday, and that just didn't happen. So they went out yesterday, and they're going to be sitting in a truck over the weekend. It's kind of inevitable, I think. And they're showing delivery date for Tuesday. I arrive at the Pabst Blue Ribbon Mansion West. I think I just screwed that up. The Pabst Mansion West on Tuesday as well. So, yeah. I'm gonna be, I think, muling a few beers along with me as well. So. My Saison is still freaking bubbling. I don't know what's happening. I haven't cracked the lid to see if it's got a Krausen or what. I've just kind of let it be because I don't need to look at it. And I know I'm not going to be doing anything with it, so it's going to sit in primary for more than 3 weeks. It'll be 3 weeks, basically, when I'm back from HomebrewCon. I want to send a shout-out to Aaron Gross for putting up the informative video on how to prepare for NHC, and I will be taking heed and putting those items together for my excursion. So if you guys haven't seen his video, it's pretty funny. You should go check it out. And push him to do more videos. Because Yondu. Ah. That's a pretty tasty beverage. I haven't even gotten to the porter yet. And it's like full out separation. There's not a... not really any blending at all. So that's pretty cool. So, cheers to half and half. What else is going on? Funny, the other day I was talking about Wicked Weed selling out. And when I went to the old K. Roger to grab some stuff for dinner and peruse the beer aisle, of course, buy these items. I asked the gal there who have kind of gotten to know a little bit, who runs the beer and wine department. I asked her what she got in, what's new, you know, and she goes, oh, I got a lot of Wicked Weed stuff in. Of course, now that they got bought out, it looks like distribution's already kicking in because they didn't have, I don't think I've ever seen Wicked Weed there. I have seen it locally at one other store. Once. And I forgot what it was. But yeah, they've got pretty much their whole line of IPAs and stuff now. I broke down and bought one can because I did a mixed six pack. So I grabbed one just to have it, give it a shot. Lieutenant Dank. Yeah, so this weekend is going to be preparing for NHC. I actually considered putting a brew down, but I think I'm going to wait until I get back. I still got a couple of full kegs, and so we're doing all right. We're doing all right. When I get back, though, that following weekend, I do plan to brew with one of my homebrew club members. He's gonna have some time. His wife's gonna be out of the country, so she's going to Japan. I think is what he said. Is that right? I think so. She's Japanese, so I think that she's gonna go back to Japan, and then he and I are gonna brew. Hopefully, gonna brew a beer. Don't know yet what, but I have a feeling it's gonna be an IPA because I've got some hops that I am just absolutely dying to get into. So, cheers. Something else that I really want to get back to and focus on, and it was actually asked of me on a comment in this week's Homebrew Wednesday, and that is my brewing setup. I really want to get moving on the electric system and get my stuff built up. Somebody asked me, when are you going to upgrade your system? Or something along those lines. Upgrade your setup. Hopefully soon. But time is pressing. So time is precious. And, you know, there's always a million things to do. If you can hear the kids hollering and right on the other side of that door. Yeah. So we got that. That and just yard work and keeping up with things and, you know, usual life stuff. So, hopefully I'll be getting to that soon. Who knows? Who knows when? But my goal for the summer is to at least get started. I'd like to get, like, the stand built and I'm going to try to get it to the point where even if I can't do, like, recirculated, you know, Herms setups, I can at least do an electric boil and electric strike water. So that's my whole thing, is I want to get the electric going, because the propane, while it's nice and it's reliable, I would like to get off of the propane you know, just having to mess with it and just having it. It's super hot, so I really don't need all that extra heat here in Georgia. I don't know if you guys know, but it's hot here in the summer, really hot. We haven't gotten there yet, but it'd be so much better to just say, okay, look, electric, you know, bam. The only heat that's generated is being used. It's much more efficient. Instead of right now, my propane just kind of blows out the side, and the heat does anyway. It's not really concentrated. So if I can't get the electric system going, I want to, at a minimum, try to, enclose that a little bit maybe, and try to reduce the thermal loss, so I don't have to, like, I feel like I'm just throwing BTUs out in the air, so I'd rather put them to good use. All right, I'm at 10 minutes, y'all. I'm gonna jump off. I hope you guys, hey, there's the oldest.
Sorry.
Hey, I'll be right there. Say hey, YouTube.
Hey, YouTube. Sorry for the interruption.
Say homebrew up.
Homebrew up.
That's right. So, don't want to throw the BTUs out. It is 10, it's over 10 minutes. I'm going to bust off of here. You guys have a fantastic weekend. Hope you guys are all doing great. And I will catch you on the next one. Let's see, we got a little mix here. Let's take one more sip before I bust out of here. That's a fine combo. That really makes me want to do a dark saison. Yes, that's a thing. I know because I've seen them. Cheers, everybody. Have a great weekend. Like I said, be safe, be well, take care of each other, and don't forget to homebrew up. And if you're going to HomebrewCon, I'll see you there, hopefully. Look for me. I'm the guy with this beard and face. Cheers, y'all. See ya.